So this is going to be part two because for some reason my camera cut out and it said it had not enough storage, so I'm going to have to film it in two separate parts. So this is part two of my essential guide for a newborn. So yeah, I was saying about the towels before, you know, don't buy towels that are, you know, the little baby ones with a little hood, because they're not gonna dry the baby sufficiently, and they're not gonna be nice and thick and fluffy, so don't bother getting those. The next thing that I would say is an essential item is a nice blanket for your baby. This one was hand knitted, and it's like absolutely gorgeous. So it's got like sort of multicolored dots on there. I think you would call it lemon drop or something like that, my mum said, but it wasn't knitted by my mum, it was by someone else. So a lovely blanket just like that would be absolutely gorgeous. It's so snuggly. I wish I made them in my size, but this is absolutely gorgeous. I take this everywhere and you wouldn't believe the comments that we get about this blanket in particular. So a nice blanket. You also, and while we're on the subject of blankets, a nice cellular blanket would be nice. The ones in Mothercare and Asda's and places like that aren't really that great. So this one's from Mamas and Papas, and it's just nice and thick and just warm, and it's going to keep your baby nice and cosy in those first few days and when they come out of hospital. And they're really good for swaddling. I can do a video on swaddling if anyone's interested, and put some comments in the underneath the video if there's anything that you want to see in particular, but I can do some videos on that as well. So a nice cellular blanket, and I'll link the place where I bought this below. Some of these bibs, you get them in sets of five. They come from, these ones were from Asda's. I think actually this one came in a, a set with a baby grow and a vest. It did actually, but you can get these in sets of five. But these are my favourite type of vests. The little, absolutely gorgeous, isn't it? The little sort of, I don't know what you call these. If anyone knows what you call them, just write it in the description below. Kind of looks like a cowboy thingy. I don't know what you call them. Muslin squares. These are about £3.50. We got ours from Asda's, but we got given loads as well. You can't get enough of these, just for like dribble or when you're going out and you're changing your baby and you'll need something to put them on top of your portable changing mat. That's another thing as well, portable changing mat you need, that can fit in your nappy bag. I'm going to do a what's in my nappy bag video as well. But these were £3.50, and just, yeah, as much as you can of these, because you'll go through them and then someone will be feeding them and be like, pass me something to clean up the dribble with, and these are great for that. And obviously you'll need packets and packets of baby wipes. I'm showing you the Tesco Loves baby wipes, and we've tried all types of baby wipes. When you go into hospital, you can't use anything that contains any extra ingredients that are not sort of organic or water. They want you to use cotton wool and water. Everyone says it's a faff, but I don't find the cotton wool and water scenario a faff at all. It's the same as using a baby wipe. There's nothing different. But to go to hospital, I actually got the water wipes. They're about £3.50, I think, for a pack of 64. I'll link it in the down bar where I got them from. I got them from Amazon, but they do sell them in Boots and Tesco's, who sometimes have offers. I wouldn't recommend these ones because they're not very moist, so I won't be buying those again. These are the Tesco Loves ones. A pair of nail clippers. These definitely came in handy. My baby was born with really long nails, so these are essential. You can buy, we got ours from Poundland, and it came in with a pair of little scissors. And you can get like a Tommy Tippy set with the nail clippers, the nasal thingy, and the, is it an aspirator, the scissors and the clippers. And they were like £17. And I was like, there's no way I'm going to spend £17 just for a set of nail clippers. It's extortionate. It's ridiculous. I don't know who even made this up. So we bought these for £1 from Poundland, and they're absolutely fine. It's a pair of nail clippers. Like, who knew? So yeah. The next thing is going back to bibs again. These Tommy Tippy ones are really, really great. They soak up all the dribble in that section, and they just Velcro up, because the only thing with these other ones, a lot of these do up with little poppers, and with a baby's head that's a little bit like, you know, you can't get around them if you're on your own. You can't like go behind them and do a popper with ease. These are quite easy to just, you know, you don't need any assistance putting a bib on. A little hat, we got this, it's a handmade knitted hat. I can't obviously tell you where we got it from because it's a family friend again. We had everything of my little girls knitted, but it's just so cute, it's teeny. And yeah, this is just a really, really nice thing. Everyone asks us where we got it from. And they, with the lilac one, they do think she's a little boy, but I love it. It's just so cute. That's gorgeous. Bottles, we use the Dr. Brown's, I think these are called the anti-colic bottles. They're amazing, I can't speak highly enough of them. The only thing is I don't like about them is they're a little bit leaky when you do the old shake with them. And yeah, so always make sure the lid's on if you do that, which goes without saying. I've had a few accidents before when we've used hot water. I think it's got something to do with the vent technology. So if you use kettle water and then do the cooling down method, then these may not be a very good option for you. But if you're using a perfect prep machine, which is a totally different video, then these work absolutely amazingly with the perfect prep machine because of the heat. I think it's something to do with the heat expansion, I'm not sure. I'll try and research it for you and do a full in-depth video on these bottles. The perfect prep machine and this bottle work wonders together. These are amazing because they're non-leaky, they are good for the baby I'm just checking on my little girl, she's just asleep in the corner. They're amazing. I can't speak highly enough of them. I don't really know why I like them. It's just basically something to do with they're not leaky. They're amazing. We did try the Tommy Tippy ones and then the teat on them is too big. This is just, from the day that we used this, these were just perfect for her. I don't know why they're so good, but everyone raves about them and I think they're amazing. At the moment, my little girl is on a 4-ounce feed, but it goes all the way up to 8 ounces, as you can see there. And these are the standard flow teats as well. I don't know if you can see that, but these are standard flow teats. And there's another question that people ask as well, which I want to get into this video. The question is, can you put any bottles into any steriliser? And the answer is yes, you can. I'm using the Tommy Tippy Closer to Nature steriliser. That particular one fits. You can put in the Tommy Tippy bottles or you can put in these, which are obviously way bigger than the Tommy Tippy ones. The Tommy Tippies are like wider, if that makes sense, and these are longer upwards, so these fit in there perfectly. It's a little bit, when you put in the top tray, it kind of overlaps a little bit, but it's absolutely fine. You just follow the process, and I'll do a video on how we use these bottles. I'll also do a formula preparation video as well for you guys if you're interested, if anyone wants to know that, and also how, with the perfect prep machine and how to make another feed. I've done one on a mummy hack video, but I'll do another one on how we use the perfect prep machine on a day-to-day basis now that she's on the 4 ounces and above, if that makes sense, 21. People will know this when they watch it, I think. So 4 bottles is what you need, four of these. The next thing I'll talk to you about is nappies. Now, we started off using the Mummier nappies from Aldi's. We started off in size 1. This is a size 2. It's her next size that she'll be going to soon. Now, these are great. You get them in Aldi's for £1.49. Their baby wipes at Aldi's are amazing. They're the ones that we're using. And you get 4 in a pack for £2.29, I think. And they're just really moist and they remind me of the water wipes. So, these ones are really good. They're non-leaky, and also they are they're fine for night times. The only thing I would say is your baby will notice that they're wetter quicker, if that makes sense. So when they've gone for a wee or whatever, they'll cry a little bit sooner when they're wearing these nappies. So if you're in the house and you're happy to keep changing your baby on a 3-hour schedule, then that's fine. If you are out and about and you're going on a long journey and you need an extra hour, then use your Pampers and have a pack of Pampers spare in the house for when you're going on long journeys or for overnight when your baby is on that longest schedule, when they're having a bigger feed, when they're going for longer periods of time between their feeds. If they're going for longer periods of time between their feeds, they're going to sleep for longer, so you want them to stay drier for longer. And I think the Pampers technology is up to 8 hours of dryness. I'm not 100% sure on that. You're going to have to look it up yourselves. But we're using Pampers at night and she sleeps the night through with just one wake. So that kind of stops us having to disturb her to change her nappy. And, you know, she doesn't feel like she's wet, even though she may have done. But these are highly recommended. You get a pack of 24 for £1.49. And then they're absolutely fine for day-to-day at home, you know, chilling at home kind of thing, that's absolutely fine. It's just the night time, as I was saying, if you want your baby to sleep through, you're going to have to switch to a slightly more absorbent nappy. The other thing you're going to need, obviously, are the other things you're going to need are bigger items. Like, you're going to need sterilisers, you're going to need your prep machine if you're going for that, or whatever method of formula feeding. If you are formula feeding, you're going to need a method to make up the bottle. You're going to obviously need other things as well, the bigger items, which I can go through as well. And yeah, I'm going to go through a few other items in some more videos. I'm going to do a series of reviews on the bigger items as well for you. But that concludes my essential guide for a newborn. Just the main basics, what you need. If there's anything that you guys want me to film, I can do. Please put comments in the bar below, and I will obviously try my best to film it for you. But yeah, I've kind of lost my way a little bit here, but I'll see you in my next video. Bye.